In this question, the elimination method would be the most efficient way to solve it. The reason you can see is that the x's and the y's are nicely lined up in both equations. And so all we would have to do is multiply one of the two equations by a negative. And then when I add them together, you can see that one of the variables over here, the y's, would quickly be eliminated. So elimination would be the best choice here.